ओके हेलो फ्रेंड्स, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज इम्पीडेंस ट्रायंगल। सो इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव गॉन थ्रू द थ्री वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट डेफिनेशन, दैट इज व्हाट डू मीन बाय इम्पीडेंस, दैट इज जेड, एंड वन वाज इंडक्टिव रिएक्टेंस दैट इज एक्सएल, एंड वन वाज कैपेसिटिव रिएक्टेंस दैट इज एक्ससी। ओके, नाउ देयर इज वन वेरी स्मॉल टॉपिक व्हिच इज रिलेटेड टू इम्पीडेंस। ओके, सो दैट इज नथिंग बट इम्पीडेंस ट्रायंगल। Sometimes in exam they ask to draw impedance triangle for 2 marks, and you have to just draw the right angle triangle and showing the hypotenuse impedance, okay, z, then the z making an angle phi, right? You remember this is symbol is known as phi. Okay, here it is a phase angle, the hypotenuse making the angle is nothing but r, and the opposite to the angle r is there will be a x. Okay, x is a total reactance. What do you mean by x? X is equal to XL minus XC. Okay, so this is the impedance triangle. You just have to denote these three things: Z, R, X, and the angle phi. Only for 2 marks. Okay, and all these things are very important. From this triangle, we can find many formulas which will be used in the numerical. So just remember this triangle. If you remember this triangle, all the formulas will become very simple. Okay, for the time we will not go into the formula. Just remember this triangle. Okay, so it is an impedance triangle. Okay, now let us see what do you mean by phase angle, phase difference. Okay, so you can see here the phase angle, it is phase angle, the angle between the hypotenuse, that is Z and R. Okay, now what do you mean by phase difference? Okay, when the word difference is come, it is always related to two things, right? Okay, we will always compare between the two. Okay, now you can see there is a two waveform here, right? One waveform is of blue color and second waveform is of brown color. Okay, now these both waveforms are starting from zero, okay, and they are crossing at pi and they are completing cycle at 2 pi, right? Means at 2 pi it is completing one phase. Now if you will see carefully, you will find that both the waves are starting from the same point and ending from the at the same point, right? There is a difference in their maximum value, right? I hope you remember maximum value. There is a difference between the maximum value, that is amplitude. But if you will see carefully, they both having the same phase, right? So since they both having the same phase, what will be the phase difference? The phase difference is nothing but zero, right? Because they are starting from, both are starting from zero and are ending from 2 pi. Okay, so just remember one thing, pi is nothing but 180 degree. Okay, so circle, half circle is nothing but 180 degree, and full circle is 360 degree, right? Pi is 180, so 2 pi is 360. So from here also we can calculate that one cycle is nothing but 2 pi, right? So 0 to pi, that is 180 degree, pi to 2 pi, that is 360 degrees. So both are starting from 0 and completing at 2 pi. So we can say here that both these waveform, here voltage and current, so the voltage and current are in the phase. We can say that they both are in phase, that is phase difference is 0. So this is nothing but just, this is just for your understanding. I have given few PPTs, few diagrams, just for your understanding to have the clear concept of phase difference. Okay, now here you can see phase difference is 30 degree, right? Now these both waves are out of the phase, right? Why they are out of the phase? Because they are not in phase, because they don't have a phase difference zero. If they have a difference in the phase, means it is out of the phase. Okay, now let us see how you can calculate. So 0 to pi is 180 degree, right? So pi by 2 is nothing but 90 degree. So if you will see that brown waveform crossing the x-axis between the half, right, means you can think that it is nothing but crossing at around 30 degree. Okay, so it means blue waveform is starting from 0 degree and brown waveform is starting from 30 degree, right? So means brown waveform are starting late and blue waveform is starting earlier. It means brown waveform is lagging and blue waveform is leading because it's starting earlier, it's starting from zero only. Okay, so we can say that there is a phase difference of 360 degree, right? Because if you will see that the blue waveform completing cycle earlier than brown one, right? You can see here at the end 2 pi, right? There is a small difference between the completion of that two waveform, right? So who is completing earlier? Blue waveform. It means blue waveform is leading. And who is completing later? Brown waveform. That is, it is lagging, right? Similarly, there was a 30 degree. Here you can say 90 degree, right? So just don't go for the negative one. Just for your what we can say for your for a better understanding, just see that blue waveform is starting from zero, brown waveforms is starting from pi by 2, right? That is from 90 degree, right? So, but you know, there's one very important thing. If the waveform is starting from downwards, it is means it is lagging. But if the waveform is starting from positive one, that it means it is leading, right? For a simple example, you can see this. Who is completing the cycle first, brown or blue? Here brown is completing the cycle first, right? It means brown is leading and blue is lagging, right? And also from that I said that if the waveform is starting from positive side, means it is leading, right? And if the waveform is starting from negative side, it means lagging, right? Here you can see this. Who is starting from negative? Brown one is starting from negative, right? As comparing to blue, brown is negative. So brown is lagging. Here, if you see the y axis, right? Don't see the x axis. See, I'm seeing the y axis. Who is at the top? Brown or blue? Brown, right? That is why brown is leading, right? Who is completing cycle earlier? Brown one. Here there is a phase difference of 180 degree, right? You can see that it is totally opposite. Blue is on the top and brown is at the starting from the bottom. So who will be leading and lagging? Blue will be leading and brown is lagging. How much? 180 degree. So I hope you understand what do you mean by the phase difference. Okay. So let's see the next topic. We have seen the waveform. Now let us see what do you mean by mathematical representation of alternating voltage and current. It is very very important. So small v is nothing but instantaneous value, right? I told you the instantaneous value, right? Waveform consists of many values at different time, right? So vt, what do you mean by t? It is a function of time. At different time there will be different voltage. That is an instantaneous value. So v, small v, is equal to capital Vm. What do you mean by Vm? Vm is a maximum value, right? The first definition, that is amplitude. V is equal to Vm sin omega t, right? V is equal to Vm sin omega t. What do you mean by omega? Angular velocity, 2 pi f. Okay? Yeah, I have mentioned also here, omega is equal to 2 pi f, where f is a frequency. So this is the mathematical representation of voltage, and next one is a mathematical representation of current. I is equal to Im sin, you can write omega t only. I is equal to Im sin omega t. Everything is same, just the only difference is the first equation is for voltage, if the waveform consists of voltage, and the second equation is for the current, right? And what do you mean by minus phi here, right? What do you mean by phi? If you will see here, what do you mean by phi? Phi is nothing but phase angle, right? You can see phi. Phi is nothing but a phase angle. So basically, it's nothing but a phase difference. So it means the difference between the voltage and current is of the angle phi, right? So it means voltage is leading by the angle phi from current. So from the equation also, you can see that. Okay, you can say that, right? V is equal to sine omega t, and I is nothing but sine omega t minus phi. Means it is lagging. Okay, now let us see what is Vm, maximum value of voltage, and what do you mean by omega, angular velocity of alternating voltage. So this is written for voltage. In the same way, we can write for current also. Okay. Well, look here. I have also mentioned here that voltage V is leading by phi. Okay, from current. So just remember, this is very important. Who is leading and who is lagging? So this is a mathematical representation of alternating voltage and current. So if in the exam they will tell you write the mathematical representation, you have to write this two equation. Okay, and if you want, you can write, it is not necessary to write phi. You can also write I is equal to Im sine omega t only. Okay, phi, I have mentioned phi just for your understanding that voltage is leading and current is lagging. Okay, if I will write omega t minus phi for voltage, and I will cut that phi minus phi from current, then in that case I will be leading. Okay. Now similarly, this is a related concept: phasor representation of alternating voltage and current. Okay. Now to draw the phasor diagram, you should know the three things. First one is the value of the voltage. That is RMS value of the voltage, right? RMS value of the current, and the phase difference between them. Okay, the phase difference between them, right? So what do you mean by the phase difference? I told you, we have seen the many waveforms, right? To understand what do you mean by phase difference. So if you knew these three things, then you can draw the phasor diagram. Okay, so you can see I, right? In the brown color I is written. In the blue color, voltage is written, and the angle between that is nothing but phi. Okay, so here who is on the top? Voltage is on the top. So we can say that voltage is leading, right? If the I is above and V is on the below, then we will say that V is lagging or I is leading. Okay, so this is a simple representation of alternating voltage and current. I have taken the general example. So this is a phasor representation. Okay, so let's go for the three phase supply. Okay, so all these things which we have done till here, we are not mentioning whether it is a single phase or look here. Basically, there are two types of supply. Okay, one is a single phase supply and other is a three phase supply. We use a three-phase supply. Basically, we are using three-phase supply in an industry, okay, where there is a hard machine, heavy machines. For that, we cannot operate on a single phase, right? In a household, our refrigerator, TV, AC, all these can be operated on a single phase. So, in the household, we require single phase. But what happened in the industry? In the industry, we require three-phase to operate a heavy machinery, okay? So, what do you mean by three-phase? Three-phase supply is nothing but we know that here, there is a combination of three voltage. Okay, there is a combination of three voltage, and all the voltage are there is a phased sequence, that is red, yellow, and blue. You can see here, all these three voltages having the phase difference of 120 degree from one another. Okay, this is just for understanding. Basically, this will not be asked in the exam. This is just for your understanding. Phase sequence. But if they ask in the exam, it is very simple. What is the phase sequence? First red, then yellow, and then blue. Okay, I have seen you can see in the diagram also, red, yellow, and blue. So what do you mean by red, yellow, and blue? Three phase, right? So all these are three phase, three voltages, and all these three voltages are at 120 degree from one another. Okay, I hope you are getting, right? This is nothing but a simple phasor diagram like this. Okay, here there is a voltage and current. Here there is a three voltage, okay? This voltage and current are at the angle of phi. Here they are at angle of 120 degree, okay? So here we are comparing the two waveform. One waveform is of voltage and second waveform is of current. Here we are comparing three voltage. Here we are comparing the three waveform, and all that three waveform are of voltage. It's a simple thing, right? So just don't get panic. It is three phase supply, red, yellow, and blue. Okay, now here you can simply understand what do you mean by what is a mathematical representation of three phase voltage, right? So you can say red phase VRN is equal to VM sine theta, right? If it is a Vm sin theta, then what will be the yellow phase? Yellow phase is 120 degree, right? Lagging from red. But they all have the same magnitude. Remember this thing. They all have the same voltages, right? So Vr is nothing but Vm is Vm sin theta minus 120. And blue is again 120 degree lagging from yellow. So what will be the Vbn? Vm sin theta minus 240. Okay. Or Vm sin theta plus 120. So these are the mathematical representation of red, yellow and blue phase. So today we stop here. Just for the three phase supply, just don't get panic. It is a very simple topic, and just go through my lectures. You will understand what you mean by three phase supply. Okay. So today we stop here. Just go through all the definitions and concepts, and all your doubt will be clear in the live session. Okay, thank you.